In the next question, we have to obtain inverse Fourier transform x of n. Now, we can write down this notation in this way also, x e to power j omega. So, discrete time Fourier transform of single x of n is 81 e to power j 3 omega divided by 1 minus 1 by 3 e to power minus j omega. If signal is 1 by 3 raised to n un, for 1 by 3 raised to n un, discrete time Fourier transform is 1 upon 1 minus 1 by 3 e to power minus j omega. Now, if we will multiply this Fourier transform with e to power j 3 omega, if we will multiply Fourier transform with e to power j 3 omega, then in time domain we will replace variable n with n plus 3, because we are going to use time shifting property, and according to time shifting property, for f of n, if Fourier transform is f of e to power j omega, then for f of n, Fourier transform is f of e to power j omega. Then for f of n plus 3, transform will be f of e to power j omega into e to power j 3 omega. So, we have used this property. So, here we have to replace variable n with n plus 3. So, function will be like this. Now, we can multiply constants on both sides of this relationship. So, we can multiply here 81 also. So, if this term is x of e to power j omega, then its inverse will be equal to x of n. So, we have obtained x of n, and it is equal to 81 into 1 by 3 power n plus 3 into u of n plus 3. 81 is power of, we can write down 81 in this form, 3 to power 4 into 1 by 3 raised to n plus 3 into u of n plus 3. And when we will multiply these two terms, then it will be equal to 1 by 3 power n minus 1 into u of n plus 3. Now, by looking at all four options, option D is satisfying this result.